Where are you going?
Away from you! It's an instinct!
Oh! What's going on?
Oh. We are completely buried. There must have been a big snowstorm.
So you're saying we're trapped?
Yes, yes. But fortunately, like all good Arctic foxes, I have hidden food supplies in every room. Ooh! Where is all my food?
Gone?
Gone? Gone where?
I use your food to feed my kits.
You have kits? No wonder you would not leave.
You still mad at me?
No. But we are still stuck. And it's going to get a lot colder.
I'm scared, Papa.
Me too.
What are we gonna do?
What I should have done in the first place. Sound the Octo Alert.
Octo Agent Natquick, report please.
The captain means, are you enjoying your time off?
No. I am trapped in my burrow by a big snowstorm.
That sounds bad, Professor.
And it gets worse. My family home has been overrun by a red fox and his kits.
I'm not surprised. Temperatures have been warmer than usual in the Arctic. So red foxes are free to move further north and take over Arctic fox dens like yours.
Yes. And now we are stuck here together and they've eaten all the food.
Don't worry, old friend. We'll mount a rescue mission right away.
Oh, thank you.
There's another problem, Captain. Red foxes often migrate too far north, and then they aren't ready for Siberia's bitter cold.
Then we haven't a moment to lose. Shellington, Dashy, with me to the Octo Ray.
To avoid any more problems, I will stay on this side of the den, and you stay on that side. And once we are safe, you will find your own home. Understand? Yes?
Yes.
Good.
Papa, I'm cold.
Me too. Same here.
It's not your fault, little ones. Come. I've got warm Arctic fur. Okay, you as well.
You know, you're not such a bad guy after all for an Arctic fox.
Nor you for a red fox. Clearly, you are good papa.
Oh, no!
You can fix that, right?
Captain, it's getting harder to see through the snowstorm.
And between the darkness and the storm, it'll be nearly impossible to find Professor Natquick's den.
Then we'll have to use the Octoray's heat scanner. If it can help find water flowing under the Antarctic ice, it can certainly help us find a few foxes.
By tracking their body heat! Brilliant! Scanning now. I'm getting a faint heat signature, Captain. Straight ahead of you.
We've arrived!
We'll have to be very careful where we dig so we don't go right through the den.
Then we'll have to take it nice and slow. Professor Natquick, hello?
It's a polar bear! Run!
No! This is Captain Barnacles! He is a friend!
He's not gonna eat us.
No! I'm an octonaut. I'm here to rescue you.
We've restocked your food supplies.
You're stocked up for the winter and beyond, Professor.
Good. Thank you, my friends. And I hope you will enjoy every bite.
You going someplace?
Yes. back to my station in Antarctica.
No!
Uncle Natquick, he don't want you to go.
You and your family can stay here as long as you like. And I promise I will be back to visit soon.
Look, I want to apologize for messing up your books and eating all your food and breaking your chair.
Like you said, it's instinct.
But I promise I'll take better care of the place from now on.
I'm sure you will do fine for a red fox. Bye-bye! Now, at long last, I can have some peace and quiet. What? I do not remember leaving that open. No. Not again!